If you're watching this video, then you want to know the best ways to scan and organize photos and albums. In this four-part video series, I'll be showing you everything that you need for a total scanning system and my best practices for scanning, naming, organizing, and storing scanned items. At the end of this video, I'll tell you how you can download my record-keeping template, which you can use to record information about your photo albums. Keep watching. Photos come in various shapes and sizes and can be in portrait or landscape orientation. And although most people now take pictures on smartphones or digital cameras, there's still a lot of physical photos out there that we want to scan and organize. To use my photo scanning system, you'll need a scanner and a computer with enough storage space to hold your scanned documents. If you find that you don't have enough space, you can always purchase an external drive like this one, the Western Digital MyBook, which was named by PC Magazine as this year's best external hard drive. Because it's important to have a dependable backup, it's worth it to get an external drive like this, which is made by a reputable company. You'll also need to know how to install and use software on your computer, which interfaces with your scanner and assists with organizing documents. Because there are so many computer and scanner models available, I'll leave it to you to decide what kind of equipment is best for you. However, if you want recommendations, please see my YouTube channel for different product reviews. At current, some of the best scanners on the market include ones from Fujitsu, Epson, Kodak, Canon, Brother, Raven, and Doxy. Unlike paperwork and receipts, which I recommend scanning on an ongoing basis over time, photos are often scanned in batches, either single rolls or entire albums. Before undertaking a large scan job, like scanning multiple photo albums, be sure to set the file format and resolution that you'll be using to scan your photos. Use the JPEG file format for the best results and scan at the highest quality possible for your scanner. If you ever want to reduce the file size of a scanned photo in the future, you can do it without losing quality and resolution if you start with a high quality scan. However, if you scan your photos at too low of a resolution to start with, you can't then make them bigger later without losing image quality. Before you start scanning, double check to ensure that you have enough storage space on your computer. For example, the maximum color image scan that this scanner produces is about 3500 by 2300 pixels in resolution and 1.6 megabytes in size. To give you an idea of how much space you would need, if you were using this scanner to scan 65 pictures, you'd need about 100 megabytes of space. If you were scanning 650 photos, you'd need about 1 gigabyte of space. And if you were scanning 6,000 photos, you'd need about 10 gigabytes of space. If you were using a different kind of scanner, your files may be even larger. So before you start a scanning project, do some quick calculations to ensure that you know how much space you'll need and that you have enough. If you want to scan an entire album like this, take the photos out one by one, starting with the last one, and put them in a small box like this to keep them neatly stacked so that they won't fall over. By removing photos by starting at the back, your pile will have your first photo on the top. When you scan your photos, take a small stack off the top and lay it face down on the scanner. The first one will be scanned first, and as you work through, the final photo will be scanned last. As you scan, pause every so often to double check that your photos are being scanned in the correct order, that they're being scanned in color, and that the scans are of a high quality. Using an auto-feed desktop scanner like this one, I can load 50 pictures at a time, and it only takes about a second to scan each one, front and back. The process of taking the photos out of the album, organizing them, and then putting them back in takes more time than the actual scanning and naming process. And while it's possible to use a flatbed scanner to scan photos, for a large job it simply takes too much time, and I strongly recommend using an auto-feed desktop scanner. Unlike naming paperwork and receipt files, naming photo files is somewhat less straightforward. Fortunately, there are a few things that we can do to overcome this problem. First, if possible, set your scanner to scan the front and back of any photo. In the case of this photo, my scanner detected that there was writing on the back, so it scanned the back of this photo and saved this note. If you generally know when and where photos were taken, this may help you when it comes time for naming and organizing. Second, name your photo files by number and by using a few words to describe the collection. In the case of this album, it contains 50 pages containing 300 family photos. I would therefore set my scanner software to name the files Family Photos and include a unique number after each photo. My files will be named FamilyPhotos1.jpg, FamilyPhotos2.jpg, and so on. If I wanted to share this photo, number 11, it will have a unique name and be easy to find and share. Third, if you're comfortable uploading your images to an online service like Google Photos, they include features which are designed to help with organizing and sharing your photos. There are also features to help you rotate your photos and detect the faces of the people in the images. Using this feature, if you wanted to find only photos with a particular person in it, you can simply search for that person's name and those photos will come up. If you don't want to use Google Photos, I suggest that you keep some simple notes about who's in the photos and when and where they were taken. Once you've scanned a photo album, stick a label on the inside cover, including the date that you scanned the album, and the name of the digital folder where you saved the digital files. So there you have it. Those are my recommended best practices for scanning and organizing photos and albums. If you learned something new from this video, then make sure to subscribe to my channel right now. Just click the subscribe button below this video. And now I'd like to turn it over to you. Have I inspired you to scan an entire photo album or use Google Photos? Let me know by leaving a comment below right now. Finally, to download my template for keeping all of your records together in one place, please visit my website, www.seandelman.com. And if you'd like to learn other helpful things from me, please check out my videos on my 7 techniques for reading faster and my 5 rules for how to hire a lawyer and get great results. If you end up purchasing something as a result of watching this video, please be sure to use one of my Amazon links in the video description below. To support my channel on an ongoing basis, please consider changing your Amazon bookmark to one with my affiliate code so that I'll get a small commission whenever you buy anything on Amazon. Please keep in mind that this doesn't cost you anything, and the more support I get, the more I can help people by making new and better content. Thanks again for watching. As always, I'm Sean Delman.